INFJ. Why? Why are you guys such sadomasochists? You're so into deep suffering of humanity, and you can just simply reside in that dimension with no qualms about that lifestyle, and it's just so depressing, but yet you're the strangely the most optimistic of all the sign types at the same time, and it's just really a walking contradiction. Why do you have to be so mysterious? Why are you guys so soft and cuddly on the outside at first glance, but then when you get to know you, an INFJ, you realize that they're this monster underneath, and they're just, you know, a person's hidden aspect of their personality is predominantly hidden. But a good way to find out is when they get drunk, they become very hostile and just bullies and whores, and they just sleep with everyone in sight, and they just can't stop whatever they're doing at the time, and just very, you know, the exact opposite of ESTP, which is their complementary opposite. And you know, ESTPs behave like that on a daily basis, but when they get drunk, they're very mellow and just kind of plushy, just like the way an INFJ seems in the beginning. Notable INFJ celebrities include Rooney Mara, Marilyn Manson, you know, Carl Jung, Mary Wollstonecraft, Simone Beauvoir, Leo Tolstoy, Fyodor Dostoevsky, Adolf Hitler, Osama bin Laden, Jennifer Connelly, David Schwimmer, Benedict Cumberbatch, me. And just as a side note, there are a lot of INFJ frauds on the internet, especially, and appearance wise they can be deceiving, but the real ones, usually you can spot them. And surefire way of finding out whether they're really an INFJ or not is by the way they talk. And usually, the way they talk and the way they stare into your soul goes hand in hand with that characteristic. And if you can't figure it out by their penetrating yet dazzling stare, then listen to the way that they talk, and you quickly catch on to the fact that they're not of this world entirely. They have quirky mannerisms that are very unconventional, and but they seem to be communicating on a different level of your subconscious, very, very deep psychologists. That's why there's a lot of psychology majors in the sex industry. You know, failed psychology. Oh yeah, shout out to Autumn Masvidal / Elle Stone. That's one of the real INFJs on the internet. But so far, she's the only one that I've seen on the internet. They're fucking unicorns, man. And I would say 90% of the INFJ videos on the internet are frauds. There's a lot of them. You know, JK Rowling, she's not an INFJ, but she specifically claims she is. She's an INFP. There's a habit. INFPs, especially the ones that get into MBTI, to mistype themselves as INFJ. Because they just don't interpret it. They don't really understand what MBTI weight works exactly. And they just see all the INFJs, like, you know, melodramatic characteristics, and they automatically think that, oh, that's definitely me. But no, they're INFPs, bitch. So, get the fuck off my block, bitch. Anyway, INFJs, why don't you repopulate the earth? Replace this horribly bleak population. Why don't you get out of your little fantasy dimensions in your own minds and come out in the real world and play.